respected officers of Grand Toastmasters Club, fellow members of this club and dear guests. As I mentioned in the first post-Dr. Saleem Toastmaster meeting, quoting William Shakespeare, that the world is like a stage where people come, play their roles and leave. But some of the people play their character such a manner that when they leave the stage, audience start missing them and remember them for a very long time. Fellow Toastmasters, we intend today to structure and commemorate this session with the life of the late visionary, distinguished Toastmaster Saleem Ahmad, Dr. Saleem Ahmad, who was a remarkable figure for the Toastmasters fraternity in Pakistan. So we have requested the family, his family members, to have honored by caressing this evening with Christmas. And we are very grateful for them to come, Toastmaster Saqib and District Toastmaster Maria. Without much ado, let me now introduce another role model, distinguished Toastmaster, who is also used to be exactly the role model as Dr. Saleem used to be in the past. Please welcome Toastmaster Sameer Lodi.
Thank you, President Shams. I really appreciate it. I could never go in the footsteps of Dr. Saleem because he's such an overpowering giant. Not only in the world of Toastmasters, but otherwise. He was not only well-known here to all the Toastmasters in Pakistan, but he was also well-known and friends with Toastmasters all over the world. He used to travel all the time to the Toastmasters convention, and the president, the directors, all knew him and had great affection for him. As a matter of fact, now I request Toastmaster Ameer to come here and give a message from the Toastmasters International President, please, Dr. Ali.
Fellow Toastmasters and guests, and this is a message from International President Balraj Arunasam. That is really sad to hear about Dr. Saleem's demise. He was a passionate Toastmaster whom we met when we were trying to form a district in Sri Lanka. A leader who never missed an international convention. May his soul rest in peace, Balraj, International President.
Dr. Saleem was not only well known internationally, but here in Pakistan, he was the sponsor and the inspiration for many clubs here. And one club which is about to be chartered is DJ, Diamond Jubilee Toastmasters Club. And we have the president here, Toastmaster Parvez Hayat. Can you please come here and just talk for a minute and also show a clip of Dr. Saab at the inauguration?
Someone who was basically a mentor to me, a person who guided me, a person who was with me in terms of establishing a new Toastmaster group. with heavy heart, I am actually not able to speak, But yet, you know, whatever he has done, in fact, for a new club, the slip is a little longer than what I thought. That maybe we will just show you for 5 minutes. You will see his passion. You will see the way he mentors. You will see his love. And each and every member of DJ Club actually missed him last time we had a meeting where we remembered him. So it's a personal loss to me. It's a loss for our club. But of course, he lives with us. His memory is here. And we will try to follow his footsteps. We'll try to continue his mission. His dream was that we should have 20, 22 clubs here in Pakistan, and maybe one day we'll see that dream come true. Inshallah, we'll all work for him. And this is one of the clubs where he came, and this is the first actually inaugural meeting where he was present there. It happened on 7th October last year. So this is a small clip from
and Major Rock Salim. Please welcome DJ Rock Salim.
Samir has got 18 words out of 24, so
the way he actually made comments, it was taken so well. You know, the example is when he started and saying that, you know, yeah, it should be, everything should be in English, but there is no alternate for chai pani. So that you can use. So such things were amusing, and yet, you know, I mean, he guided us. So again, we pray that may his soul rest in eternal peace. Amen. And thankful to what God has given us in terms of through his guidance. Dr. Salim was definitely a blessing for us. Thank you.
Now I would like to ask that today we are not having timing as such, but I'll ask the timing to explain on the timing of the lights.
Well, we are passing the guest today at the time of the day, and for every speaker, there is a time slot from 1 minute to 4 minutes. At 1 minute, I'll turn on the green light, and at 2 minutes, I'll turn on the yellow light, and at 4 minutes, I'll turn on the red light. That means speaker has to wrap up. And there will be no balcony, so I request every speaker to complete his speech within 4 minutes or 2 minutes. Thank you.
Toastmaster Najib, let me ask you, is your great grandfather alive?
No.
And his father? And his father?
No.
And I can give one prediction, because you see people predict, the soothsayers, they say, well, will you be happy, will you be rich? I cannot tell you that. But I can tell you one thing, all of us are going to die. There's absolutely no way around it. This is the journey that we go through. And everybody's end is the same, death. What makes the difference is how you take this journey. And I must say, Dr. Salim's journey was momentous. And it was a shining example. He inspired us, and not only that, we just learned from seeing him. He didn't even have to teach us. If there were two words to describe him, I think it would be passionate and affectionate. And you might think it passionate, obviously, he's such a humble, low-key guy. But yes, I think he was. Let me tell you about his affection. Many of you came to the day of the prayers. And their mom mentioned that at one time Dr. Salim used to live in Gulshan Iqbal, and he used to drive all the way to the mosque in DHA because he had affection for their mom. That was the kind of man he was. Toastmaster Rishad told me a story which is very interesting. He told me that many years ago he was working in an organization. And he had a better job, but the organization wouldn't let him go. They weren't giving him the release papers in time. So he confided in Dr. Salim. After 1 week, the head of HR called him in and said, I have received 50 calls from different people. Who is this Dr. Salim? Please, I'll let you go, but no more pressure on us. And Dr. Salim was. And Rishad told me that I could do nothing for him because people do something when they get something back. That's the way of the world. But as Rishad said, I was very junior at that time. I could give him nothing in return. But because he felt affection for me, because he was my friend, he said, I'll go all out and I'll help my friend out. So this is what where you see the true test of a character of a man. You see what the person is all about. And as far as passion goes, you don't have to look very far away than from this club. I've seen many shooting stars, brilliant people come and go, but he was quite persistent, but absolutely passionate. And that is his greatness. Today, we'll talk about him, but let this not be a dirge. Let this not be all about sadness. Let us celebrate his life. Let us talk about how he affected, how he changed all of us, the positive things that happened because of him. And I'll request the first speaker to come up and tell me something about him and his family. Maria, you told me he invited you and you liked the way he involved his family in everything he did. Please come and tell me about it.
You mentioned two words, right, that you can define Dr. Salim. One
passionate,
was
passionate and affectionate.
And affectionate. And I was just thinking when I was listening to you, said, what would I define him with? I would say considerate. Inconsiderate was what came to mind first. And the second one was, I forgot what I wrote there. Oh, positive, of course, yes. Considerate and positive. One, okay, why considerate? Well, I'll tell you what happened. It was always thinking and about the other person, about how to make them feel and all the rest. When he invited Dr. Saif, Toastmaster Saif is a regional Toastmaster. Governor, okay, from Saudi Arabia, and he made sure to invite him. I think he stayed at his house and all of that. So he wanted to make sure that we would get that type of input. And more than that, I was the president at the time, and we had a long trip to go to Hub to see one of the first Toastmasters class meeting in Hub. So he made sure that he, Toastmaster Saif, would visit Hub as well. And on the way, what he did, he said, no, you travel with Toastmaster Saif. So he left me in the car with Toastmaster Saif, and I got 1 hour almost personalized input about how to run a club, what the lessons he learned, all of that. He knew that this would be something that would be useful for the club, for everybody, and for me. So I thought that was very, very considerate. And another thing, you always thought about me when Christmas time you received chocolates from Germany. He would always say, oh, I got something for you. And I don't know why. But another thing was positive. He's always been positive, always making positive comments, and always having a positive attitude about what can be done. He always envisioned the district here, and I think we've come a long way, although maybe slower than what he would like to have done. But that's all because I think his vision, he wanted he wanted that to happen, and always seeing positive side of people. And another thing that I think I would make a comment on, he would always include his family, I think, right? Every time it was either Saqib coming to the Toastmaster meetings. I didn't know Maria very well before, but always talked about her, about how she's how good she were in the competitions and everything, and was such a good speaker. And always tried to invite me in his house. I could meet his wife. Nargis was always there at all the different trips abroad for the Toastmasters meetings, and he always showed me the photos. Oh, this is what we were doing. And look, it was really cold. I think in Sweden, he went to Sweden maybe a couple of years ago or something. He was showing me all the photos on those trips with their kids and everything. It was very, very family-oriented. And this is one of the things that I really appreciate the most. It was like very easy to relate to and including everyone. So
could talk more, but that's enough. Abed, you haven't come to Toastmasters. You had a long gap, but you told me that in spite of that, Dr. Salim used to call you and keep on motivating you, and that was the person that he was. Can you tell me more about that?
Toastmasters, Dr. Saleem is a really role model for the Toastmasters. When Sabir called me, and when he talked about Dr. Saleem, and he mentioned that we are organizing a meeting in tribute of Dr. Saleem, then he said to just prepare yourself. But I mentioned that I can't, because he was such a true person that whatever comes in my mind, spontaneously I will see. I will not make any rehearsal, any preparation. So whatever the memories will come from Dr. Saleem, I will express my views in that way. So I met Dr. Saleem in, as far as I remember, in 2005 when I attended Toastmasters meeting with the recommendation of our friend. And then I realized that Dr. Saleem, without Dr. Saleem, Toastmaster meeting, I believe, because he was president at that time and he became my mentor. So whenever I come to Toastmasters meeting, because I'm, as you know, I'm a stockbroker, most of the time I'm occupied and most of the time I'm latecomer. So he always welcomed me and give me the respect and honor and just show me that you are the family, you are the part of the Toastmasters, which, you know, which motivates me a lot to be the part of this family, because they always welcome you, they always encourage you, and public speaking is a very important part of our job. And afterwards, like Sameer mentioned, that when I quit, or you can say when I gave up coming to attend the meetings, he all the time, he was after me, and continuously he was calling me, and always, you know, we were talking on different other issues and different things, and then he bring that now you have to attend today's meeting, and every Wednesday I receive his call to attend the meeting. Then my trips to Toastmasters, like most of the time I have seen that he visit the international seminars of the Toastmasters, and he always encouraged me to go with him. And I have attended one of the Doha's competition, and that was such a wonderful experience with my other few colleagues, like Toastmaster Bakshi was there, Toastmaster Mujib was there, and we had such a memorable visit, along with Maria and her mom, she was also there. So we had a wonderful memories over there. Once I remember that, you know, we were sharing the rooms, and I was a partner of Mazhar. I believe that Toastmaster Ishaan knows Mazhar, and Mujib Saab was there. Mujib Saab was the partner of Iqbal Bakshi, Toastmaster Iqbal Bakshi, and Dr. Saleem was with his family. So in the middle of the night, Mujib Saab came at 2 a.m. and he was knocking the door of the room. So I was surprised that what happened. At 2 a.m. somebody is knocking our room. So Mazhar was with me. So we were very surprised that in this five-star hotel, that was a five-star hotel of Doha. And he said that then when we opened the door, Mujib was there. And he was, you know, very panicky. So we said, what's happened? He said, I can't sleep in the room. Then we said, what's happened? He said that my partner is snoring, so I can't sleep anymore. So then he said that I have booked the other room, which cost him almost 25,000 rupees per night. So we were there for two nights. So he spent 50,000 rupees. And afterwards he was claiming to other members as well that you have to subsidize this amount. So I remember Dr. Saleem, he volunteered himself when he said that I am ready to pay whatever additional cost in and sort of thing. So this was her generosity. But Mujib Saab, you know, he's such a nice person, then we convinced him and then he did it by himself. So always he is available. Always I have seen that whenever anybody needs, even you know those people who are not paying the proper fees, and whenever there is a the meeting is in the loss, I personally observe that he always paid by himself. And a person who was so consistent, I always salute him, always praise him because of his consistency in the Toastmaster meeting. And like Sameer mentioned, that whatever we can give to him, that we can attend the Toastmaster meeting and bring the excellence in our speak, public speaking. And you know, Robin Sharma once mentioned that the person, when you come, the beautiful life, beautiful part of the life is that when you come in this world, everybody laugh and you cry. But the beautiful part of the life is that when you go, you laugh and everybody cry. So I believe that he's the role model of that. Over to you.
Thank you. Everybody has a dream, and Toastmaster Zayat Kalia has a dream. Please come here and tell us about it. Toastmaster Zayat.
Would you like to take a trophy back to Pakistan? This was a question asked by Chief Judge to me. I said, why not? So he said, participate in numerous contests. I have seen you, and I know your abilities. I thought that this voice is similar to me. So I had only 10 minutes. I wrote a speech, spoken, and got the trophy for it. Fellow Toastmasters, and yes, but 3 years back, I couldn't speak a word. I was frightened to come in front of public. So I searched on the internet and found a number of a great man. I met him, he convinced me, and I became the member. I paid the fees, and that was the wow factor that he gave me the manual instantly. So that I can start my journey. When I was giving a speech, you all know that when I come on stage, evaluators are hypnotized. They said, Seth, you're doing great. You did well. Your gestures are well. And you're speaking with confidence. Dr. Salim was present there. He was generally evaluated. Then he guided in polite words. How to give evaluation? You are giving injustice to them. You are not mentioning the improvement points. And he gave me the advice what was I lacking. So whenever I prepare my speech and do the rehearsal, an advice pops up in my mind that I have to control this weakness. And I remember Dr. Salim in every speech, because I have still working on that. A few years later, we had a competition in KTC, and I was there to win. But unfortunately, I didn't got the first place. A man inside me whispered, quit, quit, quit. Dr. Salim met me. He congratulated me and said, you are the winner. That word sentence overcome the quit voice. And I came back again with a strong preparation. And I got the award here. But I thought that it's right time to test the talent and abilities and all learnings which I get from this club abroad, where nobody knows me, where people are of different culture and different societies were there, from Italy, from UK, from US, from India. Lots of people were there. And I participated in four competitions. The three trophies are in front of you. I lost the one. So, when we started CA Toastmasters Club, these trophies are actually belongs to Dr. Saleem, because he said to me, you are the winner, and he brought me up again because I had decided to quit. So when we started CA Toastmasters Club, he was very much excited. And he shared a dream with me. And today I would like to share his dream with you. He said to me, I have a dream that I want Pakistan, a district of Toastmasters. And I would like to share this dream with you because it left us, as it is said, bichrao kuch is ada se ki ruth hi badal gayi ek shakhs pure shahar ko veeran kar diya. Now the responsibility is on us. If you are senior and if you are junior and if you are new to this club or old to the club, and if you say you are a friend of Dr. Saleem, and if you say that Dr. Saleem has given something to you, we all have to make this dream come true. This is the dream of Dr. Saleem, and this is the dream of us. As Walt Disney said, all of our dreams can come true if you have courage to pursue them. So my question is, are you willing? Are you passionate about making this dream come true? Are you?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Toastmasters Dad told us about how Dr. Saleem pushed him to overcome his fear and limitations. Now I'd like to ask Heather, tell me about your experiences with Dr. Saleem and how he pushed you once or twice to push your limits.
Fellow Toastmasters, DTM Maria, Toastmaster Sakib. Long time back we used to have the KTC meeting in Awari campus. In during one of the tea breaks, DTM Maria, I asked DTM Maria, what is Karachi Toastmasters to Dr. Saleem? Pat came the reply, another wife. And Toastmasters is very dear to him. He traveled all over the place. He was a great motivator. I can say the greatest motivator I have ever come across. I've given about 43 speeches in Karachi Toastmasters, spending over 604 minutes. My first icebreaker was in 2007, and he motivated me to give at least two speeches on 16th June 2008. Then, one day before, he said, why don't you give three speeches? I said, okay. He said, give it a try, and we give you some breaks. You give the first speech, then skip after two or three speakers, you can give another. The first speech was 3 minutes. The second speech was, first speech was 3 minutes, the other was five, and the last one was seven. I couldn't believe myself. He had to believe in me, because these impromptu speeches are the most difficult one for me. I hate impromptu, so that's why I opted for the prepared speech, because I knew what I have to say. Then he asked me to give a 40-minute speech. I said, how can I? He said, 40-minute speech, will be the easiest one. And it was the professional speakers. I gave it. It was the most easiest speech. If anybody is in here for the prepared speakers, give it a try for the advanced speeches. It is very interesting, entertaining. And then in 2012, he motivated me to give the 60-minute speech. That was about specialty speakers. His time management skills were excellent. Because we've been colleagues in Karachi Toastmasters, Rotary Club, and Pakistan-Belgium Business Forum. And he was equally active over there, and in addition to that, he gave ample time to his family, friends, or the social occasions. I salute you, Dr. Salim. Thank you.
I don't know if any of you know this, but Dr. Saab was also fond of good food. And not only that, he even enjoyed sharing the food with his friends. He used to really call people and tell them, sit with me and eat with me. And I'd like Toastmaster Rishad to tell about his experience.
Toastmasters, friends of Dr. Salim, today is a very sad occasion. Salim is no longer with us. But over here, we are here to celebrate what Salim's spirit is. He's doing very well over there, I can assure you that, and I pray that he's doing very well. Let me tell you, the second best advice in my life was given by my first general manager in a bank, which was, make friends with everyone. The best advice was given by Dr. Salim. He showed us, and everyone would second this, to make them family members, not friends. Over here, I thought I was the prodigal son of his. But hearing all of you over here, I'm getting jealous. So, this is how it is. About his, now how he made us family members. He said his wife was the best cook in town. He said, come on, it cannot be. How can Salim's wife be the best cook in town because he is always out of the house? But he's invited not us. We used to have regular Toastmasters Central Committee meetings at his house. And the four and five members, including His Excellency Toastmaster Iqbal Bakshi, was there. Alim Raza over here, he's sitting over here. We were regular. I was a regular at his house. So after his kids, we were the persons who were mostly at his house on the weekends, on every holiday. And we absolutely, I must salute Mrs. Salim for the excellent food she used to cook. And Salim used to go and shop for those things. They had drivers, they had all the helping persons, they could have even asked us to contribute. But never, there was never one dish party. He said, my wife is the best cook and she is the manager, she used to manage. And we used to have tremendous food and absolutely the best food we've ever eaten over there. And I tell my wife that after your family, because I have to tell her, and my family, the most food I've ate in anybody's person in my life, it is Dr. Salim's, with Dr. Salim. So this is how it is. And he had time for everyone, as Dodi pointed out. He made 50 phone calls to get me released from Faisal Bank so that I could go to Hong Kong Shanghai. And I was in such bad spirit because that was the best job I ever had. I worked for Faisal Bank for 14 years and I was going to be promoted and giving my dream job in Hong Kong Shanghai. And I was losing both of them. So he not only convinced me, but motivated me, but he made practical effort to get me released from the bank. He made 50 phone calls to And they had come HR and she had to beg me to stop Dr. Saleem from doing it. So 2002, this was the year when our friendship peaked absolutely. And his favorite Molana, which was, he was the head of the Masjid committee of his area. You can grandeur of that person. Not only was a Rotary, he was a Toastmaster of international repute. And he was even in his own area, he was the head of the Masjid committee. And they used to, that Maulvi Sahab got promoted, he got the best job in his life. He became the Imam of Tuba Masjid and a permanent government job. So Saleem had to let him go. But Saleem Sahab and his family, including few friends, we used to go to Fajr Namaz right in the morning. That is the earliest Fajr in town. So we used to all go with families and pray over there in Fajr from all over town. So lastly, the best picture he ever showed me was raising of the flag of Pakistan in the Toastmasters meeting. So let's finish this by all saying, Pakistan, Zindabad!
One of the great things about Dr. Saleem was his persistence. He would never give up. And I think that Najim may want to talk about that. Najim.
The Toastmasters, honored guests, and special guests, family members of Prophet Saleem, including his grandson, future Toastmaster. Thomas Campbell said, "Those who live in our hearts do not die." And this is very true for Dr. Saleem. He's with us today in spirit, and his legacy will live on as long as we have Toastmasters in Pakistan. For those who are not familiar with me, my name is Najam, Toastmaster Najam, and I first met Dr. Saleem in 2006 when the club used to meet at Tiawari. If I were to say that I took an immediate liking to him or I was immediately impressed by him, I would be lying. But Dr. Saleem's greatest qualities were perseverance and knowing how to get along with everyone. And to know somebody's these qualities, it takes some time. And obviously, over time and interaction is when I really began to appreciate Dr. Saleem's qualities. An example of this, liking everyone or getting along with everyone is that some time back, the club officers went to him and said that we have a new member who's very aggressive and he's sometimes disdainful towards others. He said, "Don't worry, give him time and advice, guidance, he'll be okay." And sure enough, this is exactly what happened. One of Dr. Saleem's great qualities was his wanting to promote leadership, development leadership. And he was able to do that by shepherding so many of us through the club leadership roles. And today, I think there are probably six or seven ex-presidents sitting here. Lastly, I would like to talk about his passion for promoting Toastmasters in Pakistan. We all know that the social and economic conditions are not ideal for some activities like Toastmasters. But he was not one to be deterred. He was quite happy to swim against the tide. And today, where lesser people might have given up long time back, we've seen the success of his efforts in the new clubs that have come up over the recent past. I've spoken about my interactions with Dr. Saleem at Toastmasters, but I was also fortunate enough to be invited to two of his children's weddings. And there I saw his sumptuous entertainment style by the lavish arrangements, his good heartedness by the number of guests who were there and his fine taste for food. So today I'm sure, sitting in Jannat al-Firdaus, Dr. Saleem would be fondly reflecting on his achievements in this world and enjoying all the bounties of heaven.
Dr. Saleem touched the lives of many people, and there are some people whose lives he actually changed. We have a very old Toastmaster here, Toastmaster Alan, who's come to Toastmasters after 10 years, but I think he'll tell you about how his life has changed.
Today's your job is
Toastmaster of the evening.
Toastmaster of the evening. Toastmaster of the evening. Fellow Toastmasters, present, especially TM family. I must say, Dr. Saleem family is TM family, right? But I would like to speak in Urdu with permission of the president. एक हदीस है कि जब भी दुनिया में जियो तो इस तरह जियो के लोग तुम्हारी जिंदगी में मिलने के मुश्ताक यानी वो आपसे मिलता है आपके दोस्त आपके अहबाब और जब तुम मर जाओ तो वो तुम्हें हमेशा याद रखे तो डॉक्टर सलीम इस हदीस का जो मिज़दाक है और सिपाल गुजार हूं मैं डॉक्टर सलीम का जिन्होंने बे इंतहा इंकरेजमेंट के साथ एप्रिसिएशन के साथ उन्होंने इस किस्म के फोरम्स पे खड़ा होना सिखाया उसकी सिर्फ और सिर्फ वजह जो है वो उनकी शख्सियत है और वो शख्सियत को मैं अगर मैं डिफाइन करूं एवरीबडी नोज कि उनकी फाइनेंशियल पोजिशन उनकी अप्रोचेस उसको शायद गिनवाने की जरूरत नहीं है अगर मैं कहूं कि इस किस्म का कोई शख्स जिसके पास तमाम सपोर्ट्स हो फाइनेंशियली सपोर्ट्स भी हो मॉरल सपोर्ट्स भी हो और दीगर सोसाइटीज में वैल्यूज भी हो उसकी तो उसके पास जो ना उसके गर्दन में सरिया आ जाता है इसको एक्सप्लेन करो अपने फॉलोअर्स के लिए कि वो अकड़ जाता है वो अपनी पर्सनैलिटीज को जो ना वो बियॉन्ड उसको बिल्कुल जो ना वो साइड कर देता है लेकिन डॉक्टर सलीम वो शख्स थे जिन्होंने हर शख्स को इंकरेज किया हर लेवल के ऊपर उन्होंने इंकरेज किया ना सिर्फ यानी मुझ जैसे शख्स को जो यहां पे सर्जेंट एट आर्म लाइक दिस मैंने तमाम की तमाम जो है वो डॉक्टर सलीम से सर्जेंट एट आर्म से लेके और के किसी ऑफिसर जो ना तक जो मुख्तलिफ जॉब्स थी उसको मैंने पार्टिसिपेट किया यहाँ पे ऑलमोस्ट 5 ईयर्स उनके साथ मैंने गुजारे हुए 2005 में मैंने ज्वाइन किया था उसके बाद तो मैं अगर डॉक्टर सलीम के मुख्तलिफ वाकियात को इंडोर्स करना चाहूँ तो हैदर भाई ने जो कुछ कहा इरशाद भाई ने जो कुछ कहा सेमी डोडी ने जो कुछ कहा नजम साहब ने जो कुछ कहा और स्पेशली आबिद 100% ट्रू क्यों ऑन दैट टाइम वी विल टूगेदर और डॉक्टर सलीम हमेशा हमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ मोटिवेट करते थे हमेशा जब पुशअप करते थे किसके लिए मेरे लिए और ये जो एबिलिटी है वो किसी आम लोगों में नहीं होती जिस तरीके से इरशाद भाई ने कोट किया कि डॉक्टर सलीम ने पाकिस्तान का फ्लैग इंटरनेशनल फोरम पे आई डोंट थिंक डॉक्टर सलीम ही वो वाहिद शख्स था जिन्होंने टोस्ट मास्टर लेवल के ऊपर पाकिस्तान को इंट्रोड्यूस करवाया थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड एम आई राइट सर सो हम डॉक्टर सलीम जैसी शख्सियात को हमेशा इस हदीस का मजाक समझेंगे कि हम उनके जाने के बाद उनको हमेशा याद रखें। और जो सर टोपा
We've heard about how Dr. Salim used to help people overcome challenges. He used to give them challenges and help them overcome them. And for that, President Shams, please do come here and talk about your experience. Fellow Toastmasters, overstressed chairs by the live example. The objective we are here today to speak on is very much life still with us, his image, his personality, and his saints, his advisors are all around us. I would like, since the my association with DGM Dr. Salim Ahmad is spread over long series of meetings and several discussions, but to take note of everything invariably would get to be more unnecessary. So better to have few glimpses could help us outline his life as a person. I would be trying to focus his life as a person. In a few of my initial projects, he kept on pointing out, Toastmaster Shams, you need to give ups and downs. Try to give some force. There's no force in your speeches. I know you can do it. But this is how he kept so many Toastmasters motivated. And some of them successfully, you know, went ahead and they proved themselves as brilliant speakers. But particularly, the thing that I'm passionate to share with you is, yet I had not completed my first CC. He communicated to the Vice President Education that he is coming to give a prepared speech which shall be evaluated by those positions. It was something. I said, how? How can I evaluate Dr. Salim? So I requested PPE that he might have some misunderstanding. Go and check back. What's the point? He phoned him again and he said, no, I'm coming and he will evaluate me. Still I got lost. I couldn't be through. Then I phoned him. What I'm hearing? He said, I have seen some of your evaluations. And you will evaluate me, not only that, but you will be very honest to highlight any weak areas that you can notice throughout my speech. Oh my God, this evaluated me. I must have assessed myself. There's something. Anyways, he gave a very brilliant speech. There was no place, but I went on. I evaluated him, and I was very frank and clear and pointing out all the aspects that I could do that time. And he acknowledged, very nice, Toastmaster Shams. I will try to focus on the areas that you have advised me to concentrate. This is something, so I'm just giving you some of the glimpses that he, all in all, used to motivate, back up, encourage the new Toastmasters, especially the juniors, and some of them, you know, reached the highest echelons of success over the years. request Toastmaster Bakshi to please come here. He was not only a Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, but Bakshi Sahib was his relative and friend. So let's see. Toastmaster Bakshi.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster Sameer. Fellow Toastmasters, it's nice to see you here. Just in memory of my beloved friend. Well, we were relations. My Taiba, he is the Pota of my Taiba. So I am friend of his father. But once I went into Toastmasters Club, we lost relationship, we became friends. और आज की इस तकरीब में ये कहना पड़ता है कि बात करनी मुझे मुश्किल कभी ऐसी तो न थी जैसी अब है थी नहीं इस पर्सनालिटी वॉज लाइक एन एग हार्ड आउटसाइड सॉफ्ट इनसाइड आई ट्रेवल विथ हिम टू दुबई वन ऑफ माय टोस्टमास्टर quoted an incident that the snoring. But he slept with me, we shared a room for 3 days, and he never complained. So I didn't do it. And he was a very loving family. Daily in the night before retiring, before sleeping, he used to call Nargis Bhabhi. And used to give her details of the whole day's activities. So he was a multiple personality from, he was a very good friend, he was a very good family man. As far as the club was concerned, there are three things which are needed. And that was, you have to give time, which he did give time. Then you give energy. Energy in all the senses, either in medicine or in person. He gave all the energy because sometime our club could not make up the cost of the meeting, so he had to share with us. And most of the portion was supported by him. And the third was desire to work for the cause of it. The time, resources and sacrifice. He could sacrifice anything for this Toastmaster Club. I remember when he used to travel, he was a very hard traveler, but whatever he traveled, he used to always manage it according to that he should be back on Wednesday morning. So, what he used to say one night, we used to have a good meetings and our dinner meetings in Sadabahar, Gulbahar. And we used to discuss all about the structure of the club. And we used to talk about, mostly about club. And he, of course, as my fellow Toastmaster mentioned earlier, he is a great motivator. So he used to call me up, and I was at my in-law's place. So he used to say, yes, you are enjoying your sister's killing? I said, yes, it has to be accordingly. So he was, and you know, his background, he's a real self-made person. His father didn't give him a lot of things for him. He didn't have a car when he was grown up. There was only one shop in Southern, and that also was to be divided among the family. After his father's death. And then he picked up the idea of this homeopathic business, and God helped him. He's a very hard worker. In spite of the fact that he was giving most of his energies and time and everything to the Toastmaster Club, but his business was not suffering. He got the result there. Because the more you share with others, the more you will get back. Over to the
from
whenever we move to mentor, and I request Dr. Neel to talk about Dr. Salim as a mentor.
I am an engineer by profession. 25 years ago, I did something by virtue of which I qualified to be called a doctor. And that was a degree that I earned, and it is called Doctor of Philosophy. People started calling me doctor, and that started causing a lot of confusion. People came to me for treatment of all sorts of ailments. For aches, pains, and bruises is normal. But once I was on the weekend standing, relaxing on the 17th tee on the golf course, a golf caddy came to me and took me to the side and showed me his head. And he said, "What is this?" And he just whispered in my ear, he was seeking treatment for his falling hair. Fellow Toastmasters and guests, this is an excerpt from my first speech, which was the icebreaker. And I was being mentored by Toastmaster Salim, and I sent him this speech, and he gave me all sorts of feedback. "Have you spoken, how many times you've spoken in front of the mirror?" I said, "2 times. No, that's not enough. Go speak at least 20 times. I said, "20 times? Yes, of course, 20 times is not enough. I'm just not exaggerating. It is actually 20 times. And that's what I did. That's was the first speech that I gave, and I became very confident, and he gave Toastmasters Lee was there and others. I became very confident. I just scheduled myself another 2 weeks for my second speech. And the second speech title was "Be Assertive, Manage Stress." Started speaking extremely confident and telling all sorts of behaviors. It's passive behavior and aggressive behavior and assertive behavior and what kind of food that you should eat in order to manage the stress. All of a sudden, in 2 minutes into the speech, I became blank. I forgot everything. Literally forgot, and words were difficult. I just could not feel like what to say. I barely managed my time, and red light came and all the bells rang and I was just thrown out. Toastmaster Dr. Salim was my evaluator on that day, and I said that I just cannot, I just run away from this room, I should run away. And I wasn't prepared to hear what Dr. Salim had to say. But Dr. Salim stood up and just said that, "Well, what a brilliant speech this was. And this is a promising speech that you have, and I can assure you this is all of the positive things." I said, "Well, none of that." He said, "No, it's just, I'm serious." And he made me believe that it wasn't a bad speech, even though it was the worst speech. I could not prepare myself for another speech for at least 2 months, but Dr. Salim encouraged me to come and then prepare and then continue with his speech. Very good in his feedback. He would just spend little time and provide a lot of feedback. He would just, when he was evaluating, giving feedback on the table topics, in less than 15 seconds, he would just tell you what it was. So it was all, with very short time, excellent feedback that he used to give. In my project, as speaking to praise, I was fortunate that when I had to give this speech, speaking to praise, and I thought, who should I praise? And I could not, the best person that I could pick off was Dr. Salim. And I feel so glad that I picked him and praised him when he was alive. And for his children, he was so proud of you. We used to travel, myself, my children, and he, we would go, and most of the time we would go together. He was fond of telling, especially Toastmaster Maria, he would talk not a journey would pass when he would not talk about you. He was so proud at your achievement. And this is the legacy that he's left, that we hope he was so fond of your being DTM. And he was so fond of a lot of people here becoming DTM. So I wish that his desire of many DTMs is fulfilled, and all of the people who are sitting here, they continue the journey and the legacy that he left. So I again also salute Toastmaster Salim.
Hassan, you traveled with Dr. Salim at least to Hub and other places, and you had very interesting talks with him. Please come here and tell us about it.
They say you get to know people when you travel with them, and that is very much true. I got this opportunity to travel with Dr. Salim while I was VP Ed, and I was promoted to be the president of the club. We used to shuttle back and forth to the newly formed Hub Toastmasters that Dr. Muneeb established. While I was there, when we used to travel, he used to talk to me about a lot of things except Toastmasters. How beautiful nature is, what the politicians are doing to spoil what we have, minerals, a lot many other things. And I was sitting next to him hoping that I'd get a lot of mentoring advice, you know. And I'll, you know, kudos, I'll be the best leader, you know. And I was, none of that was working out. And I had this big question at the back of my mind. Why is it happening so? Does he not believe that I would be a good leader or something? So, it has apparently become clear to me of late why that happened. To understand, I had to go back a bit into my Toastmasters career. I used to live in Hyderabad. I used to come here every week to attend the meeting with my friends. Very passionate because I love to speak. And I saw myself as a good speaker. But when you are at Toastmasters, you have to be a good leader too. And once you took Asad approached me, late Asad, and he said, "Are you interested in becoming the sergeant at arms?" I couldn't say no because I wanted to tap into leadership also. And when I got to take charge of it, meetings usually have problems arranging. Toastmaster Imran is smiling at me, he's going through it currently. So, you have to arrange those meetings, and in those days, the political situation was such, it was clouded at times. You wouldn't be able to tell if the meeting would go on or not, but you had to make your arrangements and everything. And I was new into this. So, all my efforts, Dr. Salim never seemed to be satisfied with all of what I was doing. Every time he would come in, and I would get myself ready with excuses. What I'm going to say to him, you know. Although everything went smooth enough, but still I thought, you know, there definitely is going to be something that Dr. Salim might have found out that is not there. Sometimes it could be a marker missing, sometimes it could be the bell missing, sometimes the banner. Sometimes people not arriving, all sorts of, sometimes the food and all that. There was this one occasion where there was half an hour for the meeting to start, and the whole room was empty, princess. The whole room was empty, and they were just mopping the floor very easily, very relaxingly, those workers. And I was just, you know, I was just trying to composed myself. I was angry at them like anything. I just wanted to kill them because I knew I was going to get killed.
Yeah.
So, and when the first person incidentally that happened to come into the room was Dr. Amin, and then the elder doctor followed, Dr. Saleem. Dr. Saleem said, "Why? What happened? Why isn't the room ready?" They had this meeting, and then, you know, they're just trying to work it up and all that. "Okay, so where are the members?" I said, "I don't know, I'll have to talk to the VPHead." So I'm waiting for the VPHead also. Says, "Okay." I was all prepared that he's going to grill me. He didn't. But he did say that this is not good. It should be ready in time. Dr. Oni came to my rescue and said, "No, Hassan always works efficiently, and it's just that, you know, there was this meeting and all that." So Dr. Oni turned out to be a real doctor. But now this was the period during this, while I was the sergeant at arms, that he guided me and he prepared me that you can't be happy with what you're doing. You have to give it your best. And later on, while I was traveling to the Toastmasters, it was, we didn't have many discussions regarding all the leadership tasks. Only during his last few weeks, I would say 2-3 months, I was unable to attend meetings regularly. And he would call me up and say, "We are all missing you, why aren't you coming?" That went on to show how, this was all going through my mind, how he mentored me, initially trying to grill me and all that, trying to prepare me for all the tasks, the challenges and all that. And then it was at the end that he confided the confidence that he had. So truly a mentor. You find very few mentors who would mentor you without uttering words. Every married person is a mentor to his or her children, but it's usually saying, "Do this, don't do that, this is not good, this is not right." But initially it was like that with Dr. Saleem. Later on it was more like confidence, as if I grew up in his shadow. So I have very fond memories, wonderful memories that I don't think I'll ever forget, or I would definitely want to say that I carry those thoughts along for as long as I can. Truly a great leader that we're going to definitely miss. Thank you.
Tanya, I would now request you to put the lights on 1, 2, and 3. The reason being, I believe that Dr. Maria may have to leave in a little while. So just cut this down a little bit. Dr. Saleem was a good friend to everybody, and is a very old friend, Toastmaster Mulvey. He wants to talk about a good friend, Toastmaster Mulvey.
I'm a professional turned academics. My job was sales and marketing, so I've been talking and I know how to talk. I'm a teacher and I know how to conduct classes and talk. But there are occasions when words are lost. There are times when you find yourself in a position where it is difficult to express. And that is for two reasons. That today I am speaking in front of the people who are expert of speaking. And then second thing is, I am talking about a friend who was always present with me. I met Maria Paula at my university, and I just said, "We haven't been introduced," and she immediately recalled that we had met at the lunch of wedding of Sakyamuni. And we immediately started remembering Dr. Salim. And it was like, I knew him just yesterday. And then I went back to my record and I checked. I met Dr. Salim for the first time at Rotary in 2000. And then when they were having meetings in Hawaii Towers, he asked me to come to his Toastmasters club. He was very passionate about it. He was passionate and persistent in everything he did. And you may use any adjectives, it will not, I think, define his personality. He was a towering personality who lived for others. I tell you an instance, because I am from the pharmaceutical background. He came to me and he said that Rotary Club is having this project of treating certain number of patients who are suffering from hepatitis C. And the cost of treatment was about 1.5 lakh of rupees. And we were to treat about 6 or 9 patients. We started with 6. And he was the one who went around and raised the money in just 1 week.
Wow.
And he said to me that please help me oversee this project because you know pharmaceuticals very well and you can communicate and then you can at least satisfy the people who are finance experts who will look into all this. And then I talked to him, I worked with him, and he was so committed that he kept in loop with me till we finished our project. The other thing was, he was always looking for opportunities to help people. And I was very amazed on one point particularly, because he was everywhere. He was the one who was not mediocritic. He would like to do everything to the par or excellence. And in Rotary also he did the same thing. And then I remember that he organized a FET conference also, and I remember him, and I think he was a great person. I congratulate the children who are here that they were so lucky to have such a nice and towering person as Dr. Salim as their father. Thank you very much.
I would now like to ask, as you said, he was not only in Toastmasters, but he was also in Rotary. And I would like to request Toastmaster Shafiq to tell me about his experience.
Fellow Toastmasters and guests, I never forget those days when I got membership of Karachi Toastmaster Club. In those days when I met Dr. Salim, I said to him that my English is not good, so how I will be a Toastmaster and how I will learn these techniques? He said, this is only one area. There are other areas also. It's not a matter of language. It's a matter of body language also. How will you stand before people? How will you speak? Your body language, your hand movement, your eye contact. So I learned how to stand before people and I was gaining confidence. Constantly he was guiding me about different areas of speaking. And by getting confidence, I was achieving. So once he said, the matter is not that how a person moves in club. It's a matter of achieving something, conceiving something. perceiving something. You must be perceptive. And I started getting something. And about the English, I started speaking before the mirror. So I was able to come and speak about in English about different matters. And he was my mentor. Always he advised me different things. So sometimes he was giving me magazines. Sometimes he was indicating the weak areas of my speeches. And I was constantly learning. I was a regular member. In those days, my English was also improved. I improved in the English language. And I was a member of Rotary Club also in the past. I said to him that I was a member of Rotary Club. He said, why not you come in our club? Start again in your role in English, your role in Rotary. So I got membership. And always he was telling me the Rotary field, the Rotary areas. Sometimes he was saying that you are a regular member, so keep coming here and learn. And though I was not a director, he caught me in the board of directors and gave me a chance of joint secretary. I got a role of joint secretary there. Then I left because of some personal reasons. Again I got membership. He was saying that club people are they are not setting with you in a real manner. They must give you some chances. He must give you the role of vote of thanks and other things also in the lectures. And my interest was only to learn and to get the knowledge, because we have some good speakers. In every week we have good speakers. But I can't forget his companionship, his friendship as a mentor and other things. Over to you.
Toastmaster Majid told me that initially he found Dr. Salim very scary, but later on he changed his mind totally. Tell us about it. Please come here, Majid.
It was Toastmaster meeting of taking place in Beach Library. That was the first time I in fact met Dr. Salim. I entered, I saw a man very commanding, sitting with a perfect exposure, I mean perfect posture in fact. His voice was very powerful. I was a new kid. Somebody recommended me to go to Toastmaster meeting and see how things take place. So I was already a little intimidated seeing that man. Then he spoke, then my fear further, you know, sort of increased. Man, oh man, this, I'm going to get beaten by this. He was a strong leader. But when I shook hands with that man, I was actually surprised. He was very, very supportive. And, you know, he was very cooperative. The way he smiled, that all fear was totally, you know, totally got vanished. Then, in the subsequent speeches, a couple of times I spoke. There were like projects in which I was having him as the evaluator. And I was surprised. I still remember one speech when I gave. There was one Toastmaster sitting next to me. And he at that time said that your speech was not very good and you should repeat this particular project, because there were like certain mistakes that you did which you shouldn't have done. So I was myself not very confident in my that speech, and I was actually worried, and I was sort of having plans of giving that speech again. But when Dr. Salim came and he evaluated my speech, I was like astonished and surprised. He pulled out a lot of good things from that speech. And to which I was thinking that was totally, a dead speech. Then actually I found that the man is very optimistic, very, very positive. I mean, to me, he was like a spiritual father, honestly speaking. It was a good association during the days of Toastmasters taking place at Beach Beach Langin. I mean, White House, then coming to this place. There was a time I used to come and attend meetings on a daily basis. There were like a couple of occasions. I remember once T.M. Asad, who also passed away, there was his book launch ceremony. I was sitting and I was not taking part in that picture session also. So he called my name, he asked me to just join in. And because I was just sitting and trying to hide from the camera, but he just asked me to come and jump in. And he just, hold my hand at that time. So he was a sort of leader who would, create leaders. A good leader is always that who is going to create leaders. Because there are a lot of leaders who would intimidate others, and they would like their leadership to be imposed on other people. But a true leader is that when he is a leader himself, he is going to produce more leaders. So I found this quality in Dr. Saleem, that he was a leader himself, but he created a lot of leaders here at Toastmasters, and probably I'm also one of the product of Dr. Saleem.
Chris, please to come and tell me about his mentorship and guidance.
क्योंकि और हमने देखा वीडियो में कि डॉक्टर सलीम साहब मना कर देता था उर्दू, मगर मेरे यकीन से वो मुझे नहीं मना कर देता, क्योंकि असल में ये महफिल तकरीर के बारे में नहीं है, ये महफिल हिम्मत के बारे में है ना। और आप लोग उर्दू में बात करते हैं और इधर सबके सामने इंग्लिश में अंग्रेजी में तकरीर, तो मैं घर में इंग्लिश अंग्रेजी बात करता हूँ, तो उर्दू उल्टा बोलता उर्दू, मगर मैं कोशिश करूंगा ये तकरीर देना। और मैं इस क्लब के बारे में सोच रहा था और असल में इस क्लब थोड़ा सा डॉक्टर सलीम का के मोहब्बत से पैदा हो गया है ना। ये उसका अंग्रेजी में हम कहते हैं लेबर ऑफ लव, ये उसका 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 मेहनत से था। और कभी कभार बहुत कैरिस्मेटिक लोग होते हैं ना, बड़ा सा शोर से आते हैं हमारे जिंदगी में, मगर सलीम थोड़ा सा चुपवा से हमारे जिंदगी में आ गया है ना। मगर वो बहुत कुछ सीख लिया। शायद जो लोग इधर बैठे हुए हैं, हम ज्यादातर बचपन से एक सबक सीख लिया और एक अच्छी तरह सीखते हैं कि चुप हो जाओ। हम ये सीखते हैं चुप हो जाओ और उसके साथ बहुत कुछ बंद होता है हमारे दिल में। तो मेरे ख्याल से डॉक्टर सलीम ने देखा ये दरवाजा से बहुत लोग आए थे मुंह बंद, जिस्म बंद, दिल बंद है ना। और ये दरवाजा से निकल गई, जिस्म खुल गया, मुंह खुल गया और वापस जिंदा है। और वो कितने चुपवा से हमको सीख लिया ये चीज, और मैं उसको अभी शुक्र गुजारिश करना चाहिए। और मैं आखिर में एक शेर आपको सुनाना चाहिए, एक हमारे बहुत प्यारा शायर फैज अहमद फैज ने बोला कि, और ये क्लब के बारे में है ये काम हमारे टोस्ट मास्टर के काम के बारे में जिंदगी के बारे में है मौत के बारे में है और असल में जब हम जिंदा है तो हम जिंदे हैं और ये है उसके उसके शेर बोल बोल के लब आजाद है तेरे बोल के लब आजाद है तेरे बोल जबान अब तक तेरी है तेरा सत्वा जिस्म है तेरा बोल के जान अब तक तेरी है देख के आहंगर की दुकान में धुंध है शोले सुरख है आंखें कुलने लगे कफलों के दहाने फैला हदिक जंजीर का दाम बोल ये थोड़ी वक्त मौत है जिस्म और जबान की मौत से पहले बोल के सच जिंदा है अब तक बोल जो कुछ कहना है कह ले मैं पक
come and tell me about his experiences with Dr. Saleem and the ICAP meeting.
Dear fellow Toastmasters and guests, very good evening. Today we are here to celebrate the life of great Dr. Saleem. Although these are very he's a very great person and close to the heart of everyone. And the day he left us, we are greatly missing him. But let's, this is the day we should, all are sharing some good memories of Dr. Saleem. So I also have some to share. I met Dr. Saleem few years back when my first time attended Karachi Toastmaster meeting with the courtesy of ICAP AIP committee. And that day, I fell at first sight with Karachi Toastmaster Club. And Dr. Saleem was heart and soul of that club. Like a friend mentioned, Dr. Saleem like a egg, hard on the surface, but very friendly inside. So, with the journey with Karachi Toastmaster Club, he always very encouraging and giving very useful advices. In one of my speech, I mispronounced a word, cricket. I don't know whether I am pronouncing it correctly right now. Then after that speech, he came to me and said, you have mispronounced it. And then he told me to repeat it many times. Then one day, I was wearing a very tight shirt and I was looking very lovely. Then after speech he came to me and said, to be a good speaker you have to reduce your belly. And then when I completed many of my projects, then he proudly said that he had acted on my advice. Now he is also become a good speaker and also a little smart man. He is very encouraging. When we are organizing our first showcase meeting of ICAP Club, then although showcase meeting is to showcase the Toastmaster activity before the audience, but then we thought there is nothing better than a live role model for the Toastmasters. And we requested Dr. Saleem to please come at our event and give an inspirational speech. Then he said, although I was traveling, I have to go to Bahawalpur, then it will be very tough for me, but I will come. Then he attended our showcase meeting, and believe me, although there were many top brass of ICAP council, but he is standing above all of them. He is very graceful, he is very confident, and all the persons admiring him in that event. And then, in last, I like to recall the last prepared speech contest of Rajiv Rose Master Club. And in that speech contest, I put a lot of effort to prepare my speech, days and days. And when I delivered my speech, so I did a mistake, and to my disappointment, I was not able to secure my position in any third place last year. But after the speech contest, he came to me and said, "Rashid, your speech was excellent." And those words of Dr. Saleem was more than any position or prize. And with these encouragements, a person like me, who was always shy to speak in front of audience, now able to utter a few words. And I also salute to great Dr. Saleem for being here.
So, Maria, how much time can you give us? I mean, are you really pressed for time? Then you can wrap up, or do you have another question? Okay, in that case, do forgive me. I know there are a number of people who requested me. They want to talk. Please forgive me, but you have to respect the daughter. But there's one last speaker, and only one last, who will recite a poem. Toastmaster Tala, he's actually a poet masquerading as a chartered accountant.
As Toastmaster Sameen mentioned, Dr. Saleem could be described in two words, passionate and considerate, or compassionate. So yeah, he is still passionate enough to be wanting to kill me for reading and consulting notes. But I know he is also compassionate enough that he will forgive me. So here goes. I've tried to model the journey of reimagine the journey of Toastmasters, and specifically Dr. Saleem's journey, as a path led by a Pied Piper. So this is titled The Path of the Piper. They gathered round him as he spoke, more mellifluous than a thousand flutes. He showed them the life defined in line. He walked on and they followed suit. No mountains, yet they needed to climb. No rivers, yet they needed to cross. They needed to swim. There was no path, yet the piper would walk. And all they had was but a dream. Some faltered, slowed, evil left. The piper only knew to march on. He cared not how many followed, only how robustly they were drawn. The light, though, never showed any sign of drawing near, the brighter it grew. Soldiered on the merry caravan, and finally they realized the light showed, but just to guide the way. The journey was their magnum opus. Destiny was every step they took. Their voices now a glorious chorus. The piper broke his step and smiled. He knew his masterwork was done. Starlight he flew and flitted away. He and the light at last became one. Don't stop.
That would concludes the session, and please forgive me, I know there are a number of people who ask, they want to talk, but we have to respect the wishes of not only Toastmaster Maria, but his son. So now I'll hand the charge back to Toastmaster Shams, and we'll conclude the session. Toastmaster Shams.
We are calling you, that's why I have come.
I'm quite mindful we are short of time, but out of the education drawn from Dr. Saleem, I would like to share I'm compelled to share this. Everyone spoke very well upon the life of the late visionary, but my eyes got wet when Chris was speaking. I don't know why, but I guess this is because when we apply the techniques of public speaking, we try to hide our nervousness. We get nervous, but then find the techniques we use to go along hiding our nervousness. This is almost what the public speaking comprises of. Chris was speaking, I may be wrong, but this is what I guessed. He didn't take care of this. It was because of his heart. So this is again the education that we used to receive from Toastmaster manuals and all these things. The unique feature about Toastmaster here is that somebody heard, what is Toastmaster? They Google it out, call telephone, the other side was Dr. Saleem. I know thousands of the speakers who joined this club through this way. Some of them stayed for a few days, and then some continued their journey, and some fled away. This is how life moves on. Without further ado, let me call first Mr. Saqib Saleem with the huge round of applause. And he is requested to speak a few words about the life of his father and anything he likes.
Yeah. Hello. I think this is Dr. Saleem's grandson. This has been a very overwhelming experience for me and Maria. I remember the first time he went to those pastor's meeting in Abari, and he was so excited. And then like a few days later, we were driving around and he was driving the car and he was sitting in the back and he was doing he kept on doing it like everywhere. And then I asked him like, Dad, why are you making such noises? He says, because it will help me speak properly. That's what somebody at Toastmaster taught me. That if I want to speak properly, I need to open my mouth. And then he brought me to the Toastmasters meeting when I was, I think, 17 or 16 at the time. And then when I was 18 and now 19, I went to Ireland. And then he said to me, join the Toastmasters club over there, and I did. And I could see like the difference it can bring into a person. Like it can really change a person. I was very touched by what Chris said, that the moment you walk into this door, your body is closed, your mouth is closed, your heart is closed. But the moment you get out, you know, everything is open. That you become a totally different person. And I think that was his personality. No matter where he went, he wanted the person who is in front of him, who is closed, who is all sad, he wanted him to be happy, be successful, and be independent. So, over the years, he did everything so that others can be happy and others can be successful. But over the years, I think Toastmaster was his life. You know, it was in his blood. And at some points I used to ask him that, why do you go to Toastmasters? You know, why do you have so much dedication for this place? Because I've never seen anybody being so dedicated. You know, I think he must have been dedicated for maybe 18 to 20 years probably. And he was like, Sagar, if I stop doing Toastmasters, the day I'll stop doing Toastmasters, the day I'll, you know, I won't be able to make it. And I think his most precious wishes was to go to Canada. You don't know this, but he has been trying to go to Canada from the last 10, 15 years. And when he finally got his visa from Canada, he was so excited. And then he went to Canada for a Toastmasters meeting, right, in Vancouver. And I was in Vancouver 3 or 4 months before that, before he went there. And then he told me that, go and check out the hotel I'm going to stay. And I did that, and I did all the research for him, sort of where he could go and eat, where the convention will be, what bus he'll have to take. And he was so happy. I think it was his lifelong dream, and he lived that dream, and he was very happy about it. And Rotary was also his life. Like one day he woke, I woke up and it was like 8 or 9 a.m. and I was like, yeah, where are you going? He said, I'm going to Badin. I'm like, why are you going to Badin? Oh, there's some Rotary work that I have to do. I have to go and check on some people. Or sometimes he would go to NIE to check out on Rotary operations. But apart from that, I think if he did anything for Toastmasters, then Toastmasters did a lot for him. You know, it made him a great person. And there's so many memories, you know, that I have with some of you, especially with Maria, when one day my dad asked her to make Italian food at our house. So she came 2 days before the cooking day to check on our crockery, whether everything is okay or not. And then when the food was made, I think I was going somewhere and everybody was sitting in the kitchen and my dad said, come, you know, let's have some Italian food. And I think there's so many memories of it. There's so many memories of it. I don't know, like when we used to go for holidays, I think once we went to Canada, I think that was 15 years ago, he said, let's go to a Toastmasters meeting. He took the whole family to a Toastmasters meeting. In downtown Toronto, we were taking pictures. The next thing we know, we're in a Toastmasters meeting. And that was not an easy place to get into because you get into a building and you need a special pass to operate a lift to get to the maybe 20th floor. And we just went there. There was somebody standing in the lift. And we just walked in. He pressed the button where he was going, and he was looking at us, we were looking at him. He's like, what are these people doing here with the kids and everything? Then he was going on the same floor we were going, and then we just started to follow him. And the next thing you know, he was a Toastmaster. And then he said, oh, I'm a Toastmaster from Pakistan. Oh, really? Wow, welcome. Then one day he met this Syrian-Canadian guy, Yadur Rahman. Used to come here to Toastmaster meeting a couple of years ago. And he was so happy that, oh, you know, I met this Syrian guy. He's a Toastmaster and he's a Rotarian. Oh my God, I'm so excited to see him. And then when he went to Canada, he stayed at his house. But I think he really wanted Toastmasters, Karachi Toastmasters, to be very successful. He wanted Karachi Toastmasters to have a name in an international arena. That was his dream. And until I think 3 months ago, we were planning to work on it. We were planning to open another Toastmaster club in Karachi Marriott. I don't know, maybe some of you know it or not. But we were very serious about it. We actually were discussing the room and the rents and the rates, and we were very forward, and then he became sick. You know, in the end, I think he was a little bit sad. I think we all have seen Dr. Saleem as a very healthy man. Yeah. You know, if you know him, if you know his lifestyle, you could tell that this man will not get any sort of disease like in 10 years or 20 years' time. So when he, in the end, he was like, you know, I'll just say, we used to encourage him that you need to get better soon so that you could go to Toastmasters or you could go, you can open up your own club. He said, no, no, I'm not, I don't feel fine. You know, there are so many people who know that I'm not coming, and you know, they even asked me. And I said, Dad, don't worry about it, because, you know, they don't know you're sick, and you know, you're never sick. You know, he's never been to a hospital or anything. But then I think now, when he's standing up there in the stars, and he's looking at all of us, I'm sure he'll be very, very happy that you've organized such a beautiful evening, giving him a tribute. And I think he never expected that when he came for his first meeting, that he not only inspired, I mean, he inspired everybody around him, whether it's in Pakistan or out of Pakistan, and Iqbal Bakshi Sahib knows my father more than I do. You know, I'm only getting to know about my father's past from other people, but I know that you know, he started his life with only a couple of thousand rupees, and he made a very big business buyer for all of us. But he helped everybody, and he had so much time. I don't know how he had time. Like, he would get up 6 in the morning, do Rotary work, do Toastmaster work, do family work, do business and everything. But he helped everybody, he loved everybody, and he was always very positive. And if you could just imagine him, you could imagine his cute eyebrows and sweet smile. And you know, that was him. I think it was his attitude that made everything around him very easy to do. And he used to respect and love everybody. I can tell you, just share one thing with you, that he was in Afghan 2 months ago, and he was getting these antibiotics through IV, and it was very painful for him to get a canola done, and he never used to like it. So we went to the doctors, and we were in the hospital, and I said to Dad, why don't you get your IV, your canola changed, because it needs to be changed every 3 days. I said, why don't you get a change here? Maybe, you know, they're a little bit of an expert, you won't feel too much pain. So he said, okay, I asked somebody to put the canola on, I went downstairs to pay for it. And when I came back, he said to me, he was in a wheelchair, he was getting his canola. He said, Saki, meet this guy, he's the guy who put the canola on. His name is Mr. Bashir or something. You know, he's such a nice guy, you know. I didn't even feel anything. You know, like, even the guy who was putting him through a little bit of pain, he was happy about it. You know, he was so gentlemanly about it. So I think this is something that we all can learn from him, that, you know, I think if you stay positive, if you stay happy, if you help other people, if you respect and if you love what you do, everything is easy around you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We heard a lot about you from Dr. Saleem, so we were wishing if you could come in for 1 minute. Speak anything you want, if you desire. Okay, doesn't matter.
By the way, one thing I'll tell you, Saqib, even though, you know, he had his sons, but I know one thing, he was closest to Maria.
Yeah,
was his everything. I'm telling you.
Might be getting nervous or not.
Yes, yeah.
Apart from being PTO, things happen in life. A question was put up, what is the difference between successful and unsuccessful? The reply was, how you manage your time. And Toastmaster Dr. Saleem is a very live example of how did he manage his time, and he passed on the track of success, not only Toastmasters, retiring, business, family, social life, and everything around. So,
would you like to use this cup for Dr.
Yes, please, you come if you want to. Please come.
A round of applause for Toastmaster Mr. Rakshi, who would like to hand over a memento like he has arranged to decorate
Mr. Saket.
Someone from his Saket. Family.
Saket Saleem.
Please. Mr. Saket Saleem.
आपको याद रहे कि हम लोग उनसे कितनी मोहब्बत करते थे और क्योंकि उनका टॉस मास्टर जीना मरना सोना सब कुछ टॉस मास्टर था इसलिए आपको पेश कर रहे हैं मैं उम्मीद देखा
again and speaking, sharing our experiences with him again. So we are grateful to everyone for your time, your attention, especially the family members. Thank you so much and have a nice day.